they really understand it, huh?
No. Ready to go to work.
What's with the other camera?
Short. I bucked the middle.
So you bucked?
Yeah, so that there isn't. It'll hurt.
My probe will go. Robot time.
What do you
want to
do?
How far do you want to go down?
Well, as far as you can manage. Okay, if we get stuck, go down and get it.
Can you fall back to get one more dive for me?
Thank you.
asking me what the fire buildings were right there, and I don't know.
Are you doing stretching now?
I'm actually just working on some of the muscles in the back of my neck. It's a little tight, just a little muscle spasm down here. Just gonna work that out.
Hey, no, you come back here.
You say please, I'll make a scream.
Oh, God!
Yeah, go ahead.
See it?
Mm-hmm.
That's a good course. I can give my hat away. I got a fireman pin. That's the least I can do. That's nice.
ready. Guys in Philly.
How you doing, Philly? Thanks for coming to New York and helping out.
Stand in there. Are you, sir? Which team? Marion County? Oh, did we just talk to you? My wife's from Johnson County. She was just sitting up there.
How I did?
Are you guys getting ready to go in or what?
We were here yesterday.
What is it?
Indianapolis area. And what is it that you do?
I'm a union iron worker, and I do all the heavy rigging for Indianapolis Task Force 1.
How'd you end up out here?
Well, actually, out here in New York.
Yeah.
I worked on the team, and we were on alert. On alert status, we ended up on buses. And
I'm playing stupid here. What team was that?
Indiana Task Force 1.
Task Force 1.
Okay.
How about you?
I'm the same team, I'm the Task Force leader, and we're activated at 10:22, about 2 hours after this event happened.
Now you're an Indianapolis firefighter. Talk to her.
Yes, I'm on Indianapolis Fire Department, Ladder 7.
Tell me your name.
Mark Rapp.
And your name is?
Eli Hinkle.
And how do you spell your last name?
H-I-N-K-L-E.
Okay.
So far it's been hanging on. I don't like doing that. Need to check around the corner here. That's where he said the trouble really was.
Second, I got to get put your hand.
Okay.
get out of here? Where are you guys from?
St. Louis, Missouri.
You guys get in? You were here early, weren't you?
Wednesday morning.
How long will you be here, you think?
It's all up in the air right now, so.
think about these other firefighters from around the country coming in? Looks like there's about, what do I think about it?
It's unbelievable.
Yeah. The firefighters from LA and...
It's unbelievable. They take the time. A lot of these guys drove in, especially from Chicago. As soon as it happened, they were on their way. You know, they took their own cars because there was no flights going. We met some guys from Tennessee. Right, the morning it happened, when we came on Thursday, they were in a rehab area with us, and it was like, what made you guys come up? Well, we just jumped in our car and came, you know, to help. It's just amazing, the outpouring of help. It's unbelievable, it really is.
And speed.
Is this what you expected to find when you guys came in?
No, I had no idea really what to expect, but this is just hard to believe something like this actually happened.
It's like a war zone, doesn't it?
I don't have a lot of experience in war zones, but yes, that's what I would describe it as, a war zone.
Heartbreaking,
just unbelievable that this could have happened.
But you know what's incredible is how everybody is pulled together as basically one fire department.
Yeah, it's amazing how quickly they're clearing that fire. According to the firefighters, just a couple of days ago where we were standing looked like that.
It did. We were out here.
So it cleared off quite a bit.
They have done a tremendous job.
Yes, they have.
Dennis, what's this sector that we're working in?
As I understand it, there's a hotel there, one of the towers. They're just trying to clear the rubble, I think. I'm not familiar with the streets well enough to give you the exact name of the street sector we're in. But that's all I can tell you right now.
Hey, you just get out. It's still 49, it's in you all.
And Tim, just real quickly, your name?
Tim Valdez.
V-A-L-D-E-Z?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and where are you from?
College Station, Texas.
Okay, what rank do you hold in this particular unit?
Oh, in this particular, okay, medical specialist.
Okay. Go ahead, Nate.
Ready? Want to go in?
Yeah, whenever they call us in, we'll be ready to go in.
And you specialize in what?
The medical specialist. We take care of the task force members, the rescue squad. That's our main priority. Secondly is any potential victims that are found. And thirdly is the canines, the search dogs. And then lastly would be help assist any external, internal, whatever that the internal systems can't handle, you know, overload.
Does this exceed what you expected to find? Or is it pretty much what you thought it would be?
From seeing, watching the TV, yeah, it's pretty much, it's quite amazing. Really awesome sight out there to see. So that's all I can say about it.
So how long are you guys going to be here? Do you know?
I don't really know for sure. I've heard 7 days. I've heard 10 days.
Have you heard anything about them, like working you guys in as relief shift or?
Well, we're working. No, actually, we're just kind of waiting as command calls us out, like the incident command structure works. When they need an assignment done, they call us in. We're going in and do our assignment. Check in with command, let them know we're completed, and then they divvy out another assignment to whoever. So it's all based on command decisions and what the incident command needs to be done.
Most of us are all there. I'm surprised to keep shooting. Interesting story to tell on the great fire.
It was really cool when we went out there to spend time in this compound, and you know, the big thing was you go out and have you a big hunk of beef, and then you
come.
Biter. Yeah, that's it. That's East Texas, man. And if you can't say the names right, they run you out.
Well, he was telling us stories about how his...
Open up.
think that'll wipe up this. I'll take it.
Ready to go in and cut. Should we wait?
Yeah. Thank you.